Fort Portopua funding reports came to light as members of parliament on the Committee of Government Assurances were interacting with leaders from Fort Porto, led by the mayor, Edson Asaba Rionga Adieri. The committee was shocked at how poorly roadworks are funded.
As a committee, we've come to see whether government is implementing the promises it gave to cities by creating new cities. But what we have discovered here is that before it was a municipality and it was running a budget of 1 billion to repair 128 kilometers of road of their roads. Now, when the scope was widened to a city, it acquired 500 kilometers of road. And the budget for making the roads reduced to 800 billion.
But all what we are saying, that they are so meager that we cannot make ends meet at all. Two, that more often than not, they make conditions so tough.
By 2020, Fort Porto City authorities were struggling to deliver services and improve infrastructure due to lack of funds and operational guidelines. This was further worsened by the High Court cases which Fort Porto was being demanded by those that won cases in court against it. The leaders have highlighted the situation at hand.
Government and finance. Lastly, we have had a lot of litigation and cases. We ask the local government to create boundaries and provide share assets between the former government, local government, and the new cities. This has not been done up to now. And this is because they have refused to put up a statutory instrument or law that governs sharing of this asset.
They are worried because most of their properties might be attached by the courts. So we therefore request the Minister of Local Government come on ground, find a quick solution for such cases so that we can have a good developing city.
Joseph Gonzaga Sewungu, the committee chairperson, has tasked the local government to solve the litigations that Fort Porto is facing. Some committee members also expressed their displeasure with government challenging leaders on service delivery.
They have talked about court cases and the ones they have lost. But we have asked them to provide us with that information. But still, it goes to local government. Because when they are showing this municipality or city, they show the Attorney General, local government, and them. So what has local government and the Attorney General done to sort out these litigations? Because at the end of the day, these people don't have money to pay back if they lose their cases.
Edson Asaba Rionga, the Fort Porto Tourism City Mayor, also revealed that the road funds received come with a number of conditions at the end of every quarter before the money is being used for its intended purpose.
In such a way that money is going to be given to you in the fourth quarter. When you have only 3 months to construct that road and then finish up the money. But even to add abuse to injury, they give it to you in the last month of that quarter, whereby they very well know that you will not touch that money. Because there is a procurement, there is this and so forth and so on. And before you even go halfway in procurement, the deadline has struck. And the money goes back. And you will never get that money.
Story compiled by Jonan Tusingwire for the news.